There is growing skepticism about the expected coronavirus vaccine that may be founded in fear rather than fact. But scientists warn it could threaten whether Americans will be willing to take the shot whenever it becomes available. Vaccines, of course, are one of the great breakthroughs of modern medicine. They helped eradicate devastating diseases like polio, smallpox, and measles in the U.S. But now the anticipated breakthrough of a vaccine against the novel coronavirus is becoming a political football.
We're very close to having a vaccine. If you want to know the truth, the previous administration would have taken perhaps years to have a vaccine because of the FDA and all the approvals. And we're within weeks of getting it. You know, could be 3 weeks, 4 weeks, but we think we have it.
He said 3 weeks, 4 weeks, even though earlier in the day, yesterday, a day that, mind you, there were no vaccine breakthroughs that occurred that would have changed the timeline. This was the timeline that he gave.
We're going to have a vaccine in a matter of weeks. It could be 4 weeks. It could be 8 weeks, but we're going to have it. Now, will it be before the election? It could be in terms of we have something.
It's like he's just making up the timeline. But whether the president says 3 weeks or 4 weeks or 8 weeks, it's an unrealistic timeline, according to the president's own aides. His vaccine chief, Moncef Slowey, said yesterday in the New England Journal of Medicine that, quote, developing a vaccine by January 2021 will represent remarkably speedy scientific progress. But administration officials who are working on a vaccine are doing so under pressure cooker conditions at the FDA, according to a new CNN report, as the president is seeking a political victory. The CDC has told states that they must be ready to distribute the vaccine as early as November 1st, 2 days before the election. But Slowey still says this.
If we can make them advance prior to the election day, we will. And if we can make them advance after the election day, we will. It's totally irrelevant. It's very unlikely that that number happens in October. It's more likely that it happens in November, and it's even more likely that it happens in December.
President Trump's rushed rhetoric around the vaccine, rhetoric in the service of politics and not in the service of public health, is causing many Americans who would not consider themselves anti-vaccination to now have reservations about a potential coronavirus vaccine. According to a CBC News poll conducted earlier this month, only 21% of people said they would get a coronavirus vaccine right away if it became available. That is down from 32% who said they would in July. Senator and Democratic vice presidential running mate Kamala Harris said this when my colleague Dana Bash asked her if she'd get a vaccine that was approved and distributed before the election.
Well, I think that's going to be an issue for all of us. I will say that I would not trust Donald Trump, and it would have to be a credible source of information that talks about the efficacy and the reliability of whatever he's talking about. I will not take his word for it.
Now, the issue also came up in a senatorial debate in North Carolina when Cal Cunningham, the Democratic challenger to Senator Tom Tillis, said this.
Look, I've got questions, and I think we have seen entirely too many times, and especially in recent years, politics intervening in what should be driven by health and science. Whether it's CDC, Center for Disease Control suggestions and recommendations on how we deal with this pandemic, we've seen politics intervene there.
Do I read you to say you would be hesitant to receive the vaccine if it were approved by the end of the year?
Yes, I would be hesitant.
We just heard a candidate for the U.S. Senate look into the camera and tell 10 million North Carolinians he would be hesitant to take a vaccine. I think that that's irresponsible.
Now, if Democrats see political opportunity in fears about a vaccine, it is unethical for them to seize it. No one should be playing politics with the health of Americans. But Cunningham's sentiment is shared by a growing number of Americans. And for many, worries about the vaccine start with the president, a president who says this about masks.
I think wearing a face mask as I greet presidents, prime ministers, dictators, kings, queens, I don't know, somehow I don't see it for myself.
No, I want people to have a certain freedom, and I don't believe in that, no. And I don't agree with the statement that if everybody wear a mask, everything disappears.
There are a lot of people think the masks are not good. And there are a lot of people that, as an example,
who you have- Who are those people?
Well, I'll tell you who those people are. Waiters.
For many people worried about the vaccine, it starts with a president who resides in a world where everyone around him is tested as he lies about how bad the pandemic is.
We're going to get through this, and we're right now, I hope, really think we're rounding the final turn.
A president who has known for 6 months how easily coronavirus is transmitted.
You know, the touch, you don't have to touch things, right? But the air, you just breathe the air, and that's how it's passed. And so that's a very tricky one. That's a very delicate one. It's also more deadly than your strenuous flus.
A president who has suggested cures that have killed people when they have tried them.
Then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning?
President Trump, who touted hydroxychloroquine, an unproven drug in the treatment of coronavirus, and whose FDA issued an emergency use authorization for it only to revoke it in the face of what it described as, quote, ongoing serious cardiac adverse events and other potential serious side effects. Trump administration officials manipulated CDC data, we have learned, to make it track with the lies that the president was telling about the virus. And now, after all of this, he wants the country's trust on a vaccine. How do you trust someone who has repeatedly shown they are not trustworthy? Trump has politicized the virus, and it has cost lives that we will never get back. And if he doesn't stop politicizing the vaccine, it will cost more. A recent Kaiser Family Foundation poll shows almost two-thirds of Americans believe political pressure from the Trump administration will cause the FDA to rush approval on a vaccine before Election Day. And the folks most likely to say they would not get a vaccine, even if it is ready, if it is available, and if it is free before the election, they are Republicans, not independents, not Democrats. They are Republicans. They are his supporters. These are the lives of his supporters.